Boiler room.
Well,
Hurry up, girls. Can't waste time. I got my socks on you. Hurry up. Hurry up.
Now
Mr. Haskell's looking for you.
If you get lost, I have to fix the number 9 issue. I expect you to be shipping.
Well, I don't want a super to try and shove me around. maybe what about that kid that got hit with a super app to save for himself?
Well, that's one for the birds, Prez. That kid hasn't even got a bruise on him. He's a faker.
You think so, puppy?
Sure, he's a phony. If that guy's Sorokin ever really hit him, he'd break him in two.
Okay.
Mr. Sorokin is so strong.
He's so wonderful. What's this?
The new super. I think he's simply woo-woo. Don't you?
I didn't notice.
I noticed.
I thought maybe you were noticing too.
Yeah, she lit up.
You girls are getting...
Love comes at last today, William.
Oh, get off it. I hardly even looked at the man.
I'm the grievance committee.
Love? Are you nuts?
Some people can't tell when it hits them.
All you gotta do is say hello to a man, and they've got you whispering in his ear. All you gotta do is be polite with him, and they've got you spending the night with him. If there's a guy you merely have a beer with, they've got you standing the wedding date.
Shouting!
I have
there always seems to be a demand for it.
What do you want to sell the real stage?
That's where I first met a poopsie.
He was throwing knives at a woman at the Majestic Theater.
Is Mr. Hatzler in his office?
No.
Here, one hard-earned dollar. Now, honey, I hope the ham ain't as salty as it was for the last union picnic. I was dried up for a week after.
What are you going? Leaving him a note, huh? Carrying on with Sorokin, huh?
Oh, Vernon!
I saw you leave that note on his desk. I'm not blind. That's why you wore that low-neck dress to work today.
You make me scream, Vernon! You just make me scream!
All right, then what's in it? I dare you to tell me what's in it.
Read it, then you'll cut your throat.
Okay, payroll $7,502.01.
That means I love you in Morse code.
Ain't you ashamed of yourself, Hindsie?
Now that we got that all settled, you think you could trust me as far as the ladies' room?
Never be jealous again, Mabel. Never.
Maybe I'll give you cause someday.
Oh, Hindsie.
country today. Offices on every night. It should be in every executive's contract. What is this? This should be here. Gladys! Gladys!
Yes, Mr. Hassler?
Where are you?
I've been to the ladies. Isn't that all right? Oh, Mr. Hassler, you scared the life out of me. Look, I've got the cure on my neck. It's all right.
I'm not one of them. Why? If I can't trust Gladys, you can't.
I wouldn't know.
What's that book doing here anyhow?
Say, Sid, who is this Fulton Lewis Jr. he's always talking about?
He plays third base for the Chicago White Sox. The old man's got a baptism book I just had to
do. Oh, yes.
I wonder if he's got a skeleton box in there. Say, Mabel, tell me something. What kind of a girl is this big boy?
Bay? She's peppy, full of spunk.
Is she married?
No, not quite.
What do you mean not quite?
Well, she was close once. She was engaged to the Johnson boy. Then, one time at a football game, she pushed him off the end of the bleachers and gave him a concussion. That broke the engagement.
Out for a girl. Gladys is crying. She's hysterical. I don't know.
She brought the ledger up here to enter the cost total, Mr. Hassler.
Well, what the hell? Didn't someone say so?
Jim, you need a text. Is this you, Trent? Slowly speaking. Sid, whatever happens to the complaint down our eyes before it goes off? I'd like to get it settled.
Would you send the grievance committee up to my office?
No, thanks.
I heard you had an eye for her.
You're being easy around this week. First thing you know, they'll be talking about us.
Don't think it hasn't been mentioned.
Memo? Cutting for me. Too many rejects. Andre on paper numbers. Come in.
Hello.
Have a seat.
Thanks.
Looking good and before back.
Yes, Mr. Hassler, I will be right there. Gladys is still crying and he wants me to take a couple of letters.
I want to talk to you about that assault and battery case.
Oh, well, we thought we would just forget about that, Mr. Strogan.
Yes?
Yeah, we all knew that injured arm was just a lot of nonsense. And to tell you the truth, we got trouble with it before.
Well, I can believe that. If you only knew what I had to do to get him to kick her cross with a screwdriver, now I'd have been justified by soft him.
Well, we won't go into that. But anyhow, we'll have it in our books as a slight nudge.
Well, personally, I think a little physical punishment is good for people once in a while.
Oh, you do, Captain Bly?
No, not exactly. Sit down for a second, will you, Miss Williams? I want to talk to you. How about a date?
What?
How about going out to dinner tonight?
Well, I don't know.
Maybe check up on some of the local hotspots.
Thanks. But I don't think so.
What is the strange power I have over women?
It really wouldn't work. Not at all.
Looks like I struck out that time.
Well, it's nothing personal. It's just, you're the superintendent, and I'm the grievance committee.
Memo? Timekeeper. Be sure all the girls fill out their time cards properly. And check. Memo, Cicero.
There, you with the stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. Hey there, you are that high-flying cloud. Has it dancing on a street?
Chili Coke, Vanguard, Napoleon. The finest season I ever had.
Well, seems we'll have to make an announcement about the mix-up. Breaking the mean of baked beans to go around.
Oh, okay.
But there's plenty of pita salad. For them that don't care for baked beans can go heavy on pita salad, and vice versa.
Where's Lindsay, Gladys?
Oh, he couldn't keep up with me.
Boy, they gotta be good to keep up with you. This is the day I say let yourself go, huh?
You wanna go someplace?
Oh, you know what I mean. Say, that's a mighty nifty outfit you got. I go for that.
I don't know. I brought a dress along too, but Heinzie says it's too cold.
It ain't too nutty. You tell Heinzie to go bull hoop down Main Street. You got class, honey. You're beautiful.
I know I'm beautiful. I'm just the most beautiful girl north of Kyoka, Iowa. But you got a wife, Prez.
Aw, forget about that. Her and me are total strangers.
Oops.
Listen, baby. I wouldn't never tell this to nobody else but you. To nobody else but you, I wouldn't never tell this. What I mean to say is you're different from the rest. Maybe you're the best. time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you, at this time, somebody who you actually need no introduction on account of we all know him, and it's always a pleasure to have him in our midst. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you our boss, Mr. Myron Asler. Okay, Mr. Asler.
Thank you. I'm proud to be with you. We're all members of a great industry. To that industry, we owe our lives and our daily bread. In return, we must recognize the stern obligation placed upon us in these terrible, terrible times of economic upheaval, governmental chaos. I can never remember a time when competition was so ruthless. Dealers, cantankerous, costs outrageous, and profit margins sub solo. My good friends, pajamas like crossbones, whether your factory can weather the storm of rising costs is a grave question, I think.
Thanks, Mr. Hasler. I'm sure we all enjoy hearing from you. It's certainly nice to have you with us. First thing after we leave the festive board, there will be a night throwing exhibition by Professor Vernon Hyde.
And I never miss.
The baseball game starts at 1:30 sharp between the finishing room and ladies' pin. The brush contest and it ought to be good. Now, who wants to be my partner in the three-legged race? That's all.
Me for baseball? I want to be in the three-legged race.
You can't win if you don't practice.
Hear ye, this way for the dice throwing.
Hello, gorgeous. How about another beer?
All right.
This way?
But the refreshment stand is...
No, it's out this way.
Hear ye, this way for the dice throwing.
Well, if it isn't this grievous
committee. Oh, hello.
I have a grievous. There's a new fellow to be named Cicero. Did knock himself out trying to be a dandy fellow, but he can make a score.
Say, Eddie, I want to learn from this.
Oh, well, you tell him Miss Williams is a very cold hearted doll, and he wouldn't like her very much if he got to know her.
I'll tell him, but he's not the problem. Stubborn as hell.
No, I don't! Some people have no sense at all, darn fool.
What happened to you?
Stay out in the open, honey. Don't go down in the woods.
Now! Hurry! Make way for the old professor!
Wait until I place my knife.
Hurry! For a ride of thrills, introducing Professor Vernon Hines, master of the flying blades. In his sensational demonstration of iron nervous skill, and sadly as performed in his professional appearances before the crowned heads of Missouri and Kansas. Are you ready, Professor?
I am ready. Say, is the trained nurse in attendance?
Yes, the trained nurse is here.
The excitement may prove to be too great a strain on some of our first spectators. Ladies and gents, your kind attention. Here we go. One, two, three.
Making
you nervous. How the hell do you think I feel?
I think that's enough. new policy for both of you.
Oh?
Let's quit the fighting.
What fight?
Come here, Catherine.
Where are we going?
Babe and Sim are going for a walk together. The new policy.
You got such a swell break.
So do you.
you're right.
I always say, a railroad man can pick no one should have done best. Don't see any home enough.
You go out on your lunch tonight, don't you?
That's right. Up to Milwaukee, doggone it. Say, here's something you don't see every day.
I agree. What is it?
A petrified bat.
Now, Pops isn't interested in any petrified bats.
I have gone back. I didn't see he was.
No,
the tyranny of women. Too bad. Well, I better pack my things. Hold number 15. Wait for no man.
Pop belt your ears off.
He's a great guy. I like him. But I like you better.
All right. Wait till Pop gets back. Are you hungry?
No, not exactly hungry. Not the way you mean, anyway.
Here, have a beer.
Thanks.
Say, Sid, do you like stamps?
Huh?
Well, even if he doesn't, this is something that should be interesting to anybody. Two sets of the Camino, late blocks of every issue since 1919.
Well, thanks.
Goodbye, Katie.
Bye, Pop.
Sid, come on anytime.
I'd like to. Well, now we can settle down for a nice long evening with this stamp album. Say, he has got a full set of Colombians.
Sure he has. That's why I work at sleep time.
He's a nice guy, babe.
You're a nice boy, Sid. He likes you too.
Feel good, babe. I feel at home.
I wonder if we got any onions.
Onions?
I'm gonna make a western. Do you want one?
That's my baby boy. She wants a western. No, honey, I do not want a western. Food is not the most of my thoughts at the moment.
Well, then I guess you want some coffee, too.
No, it'll keep me awake. Now cut it out.
Thank you.
No, baby, why should we be?
Sid, there's something going to come between us.
Who?
Not any who. 7.5 cents.
Oh, that.
That contract, lover, that's important. Maybe we ought to face that.
No, don't talk nonsense.
Sid, you mustn't treat me like a baby.
I'm not, darling.
Then you've got to listen. I don't know why the union's so important to me, but it is. I guess you gotta be on a team. But that's why no matter what's with us, I'm going to be fighting for my side and fighting hard.
All right. How do you feel about me, babe?
I love you terribly.
If we both feel that way about each other, isn't that enough?
You don't know me.
Babe, I love you.
Yeah.
He's a fire, he says. What a lie.
You should have heard it, babe.
Wait a minute, please. Mr. Haskell wants to speak to you again.
More soft soap.
Now, babe, quiet down.
Now. I just want to add one more thought. Let's not interrupt any our feelings. We want to preserve that fine, sleep-tight view.
That's easy to say, Mr. Hasler, but we're not getting any place.
We're going backwards.
I didn't say no. I said not now.
Look, Mr. Hasler, this thing's been dragging on for months. Help are getting very jumpy. Their patience is about to run out.
I want to be fair, but...
Listen, I'm going to tell you the plain truth. We know this company's doing one hell of a business. We don't have no education, maybe, but we got eyes and ears.
Yes, everyone in the industry has a 7.5-cent raise.
As I said, I want to be fair. That's always been my policy. So I don't give you a yes, but I don't give you a no. I say we've got to examine it. And I have to talk to the board, and that's where we're going to leave.
What now, Prez?
Slow down.
Attaboy, this is it. There's the bell. This is what we've been waiting for. Gotta get started someplace.
Slow down. Babe, you're in charge of this room. Go to it. Slow down.
Not seen things to believe.
Vecna wants to get over to the tri-state, he will have plenty of time. What's going on down to the plant, you all know, has been designed. Many members of the type I run into from time to time and say, what good is it you? Why should I pay my dues? Why, they can get a mighty good object lesson for where would they be now in this here battle for the 7.5 cents that they wouldn't be getting if it wasn't for the union? But sure as hell gonna get it! Believe us all remember that the union be first and foremost in our minds. Next, only to our loved ones and the tiny tots and kids. Now, before we break up, we are going to have a little bit of a few minutes. I hope you are going to show a special courtesy tonight, because a couple of the technical boys have got up and acted Gladys Hotchkiss for the front office. And if these good folk is good enough to come down here and do this act for us, why, the least you can do is not sneak out the back way, like last time. This little number they worked up is right on the nose, because it's about getting hot. Fellow shooting members, that's what we're doing. Getting hot.
Thank you.
down here and do nothing. We gotta make plans. Ours weren't gonna give it so easy.
We gotta slow down.
I mean, other things, more like, for instance, like my suggestion here from Jake Fogerman. He said he was working at that high overall company and they was having trouble. Why, they spit tobacco juice in the back of pockets of the overall.
Whoa, I'm reliant chewing tobacco.
I wasn't suggesting that.
How about the package with the sidelines on, the sides fall off, so like that?
Sure.
Now that's what I mean. That's construction. That's
hello?
Oh, I'm sure I recognize your voice.
But that would take affection not.
I suppose not. Yes, I am.
Let's be practical.
Oh, I'm gonna break down the window here.
I've been away 3 days.
No, we gotta put the screws in them right now, not later.
Look, I have several people here and it wouldn't do any good. So, I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Babe David's saying, look, I don't want to get David into trouble here, but...
Go ahead. What trouble can he get me into?
I'm fired already. Well, the union ought to do something about that, too.
If she hadn't stood right up and said she did it, we could have. There's somebody up and admits they just doesn't have the property. Listen, here's a confidence just inside the committee. Some of the button teams went on too good. Wait till the salesman comes screaming back to Aslan.
Hello?
Mr. William.
Big meeting, hey! Hi, Ben.
Hi, Pop.
How are you doing?
How's the trip?
Oh, Dirty, got another hot dog on the signing for 25 minutes.
That's about it.
Sure. And we all gotta think of new ways to jam things up.
Much obliged for the beer.
That's all right.
What do you mean you gotta get home?
Listen, May, my wife will be raised in hell.
Too bad you didn't think about that before.
Look, I'll take you home.
Don't bother.
But May, there are flowers out at this hour of night.
Single ones, I hope.
Come on, Joe.
Say, you stopped in down at the corner doctor for a beer just now, and guess who I ran into?
Old man Hassler and Rita Haymore?
No, Sid.
Oh. Sid, what's he up to?
The way I heard it, he just been phoning you or something of that kind. What happened with you two?
Never mind, Pop.
That's what I told Sid. I told him, forget it, and come on up.
Oh, Pop, you're too fat.
That boy doesn't feel good about something, babe.
Well, neither do I.
Come on in, Sid.
Yes, do come in.
Make yourself comfortable.
Have you really been away?
Sure. I went to Chicago to visit the Lincoln Park Zoo.
Just because we're on two different sides. Is there any reason for you and me to get all balled up?
Looks like it, doesn't it?
Talk to me, it doesn't. What kind of a queen are you anyway?
Haven't you heard? I'm the sweetheart of Local 343 Associated Garment Workers in North America. My constant. I warned you. I told you, you know. You know all about how I felt. I happen to think there are certain things a person should stand up for in this life. I guess you forgot all about that.
I forgot nothing. They paid it on the factory.
So run the factory. You stick to your side and I'll stick to mine.
Look, Miss Williams. I love you. Courtney, ain't it? Did you hear me?
Yes.
Babe, can't you see my side of it? I can't fail at this. I was cutting from Portland when I bluffed my way into this job. And I'm going to fight to stay here. But now that I got you in my plan, I'm fighting to be smarter.
Watch those hands, I do.
Well, here we are.
What are you up there, Pop? Your stamp album?
Now, don't get too excited. Why, if Sid doesn't want to look at it, he doesn't have to. No longer is my looking at it, is it?
But Sid likes stamps. He told me so, don't you, Sid?
Yeah, I was looking at it. Really nice.
Sure, there's a universal appeal in stamps. I knew you'd be interested.
Sid is very interested. With me, I'm just plain bush. You mind if I just go out to bed?
Run along, honey. Good night, dear.
Good night. Sleep well.
Thanks.
Sid, stay till we start with the plan of many men.
I guess that's a good place to fire up the men.
Baby, you
a disgrace to my training. You're hurting my feelings.
Mr. Hines, we need to hurt your feelings. Oh, I'm so sorry. It's really personal, Mr. Hines.
It cuts. I have the notion to throw away my stopwatch and give up.
We'd like to train us all over again.
Where's Mr. Haslam?
I thought you were Peoria.
I asked for Mr. Haslam. I give Peoria. Don't tell me you wanted to slow down. Never mind. I'll probably do this.
Did you hear that?
He seems awfully upset.
So here's me on the slowdown.
Oh, not you.
Me, a man who's lived his life by the clock.
We're sorry, Mr. Hines. We'll be good.
Yeah. Sure, yeah.
Take your pants off.
No,
Mr. Haslam, this is songs.
Let's take your pants off.
Be honest.
Go on, come on.
Oh, what a day!
I'm a very busy man. I'm a time study man, not a bottle.
This is all for sleep type this.
Hines! Put those pajamas on. Hurry up! Get over it!
Now, Mr. Haskell, I want you to get a picture. I was showing this to Todd Robinson of the Robinson Brothers. Now, I ain't one of your type sailing room that believes in half measures. Whenever we get a sailing room, I do just what we got time to do it. I'm out of breath myself.
Beautiful silent. What more could you want?
Now wait, here I am in Peoria, and I'm modeling the pants. Mr. Robinson, these two guys are very impressive in line. Everybody's a buy. Get the picture.
Go on, go on. What's the point of all this?
Now, Hines, take a deep breath, stick out your stomach.
This is truly ridiculous.
Everybody bear in mind, I got these pajamas, I will stop. Right out of the box. Now, go on, Hines, breathe in.
Come on, Hines, sit to breathe. Breathe! Let's get over!
Oh!
My God!
I'm sorry.
We'll leave him late.
What are you doing? Are you playing games?
Mr. Hines, really?
Let me see those.
They're all like that. Everyone. Boxes and boxes.
What's the idea? Who did this?
Somebody's got quite a sense of humor.
What the hell are you talking about?
Two threads in every waistband button.
What?
They're not so large. Only two threads. Somebody's being very cute.
Cute? Sabotage! Open rebellion!
You're gonna have to fight me just
with all put your pants on!
You've never finished your story. What did this Robertson fellow do when your pants fell down?
He left. No sense of humor.
Well, keep your hands off me. Hold the orders, we'll check the stock. We'll be right down. Come on, man.
Anything right now.
You're busy.
Hey, Lloyd, the same what we say.
You abandoned woman!
password, please. And what's more, I think I got something.
Take it easy, boy.
Mr. Hassler, could you come down to the office right away? Come in. It's pretty important. Thanks. Come in, please. Sorry to drag you all out here so early, but I knew you were going to have a union rally, and I wanted to talk to you first.
That's okay, sir.
I think I've got to hold some facts and then clean up this mess. Well, it better be quick. We either get that 7.5 cent wage or we strike.
You're damn right.
What I need to ask is, will you keep the rally going until I get there and talk to you? What about? About solving this damn thing.
There ought to be a time limit.
All right. You're going to have a parade.
You are?
And I'll give me time. I'll be at the rally.
That's fair enough.
Oh, and Miss Williams, can I speak to you?
We'll wait for you downstairs, baby.
I know explanations are allowed.
Oh, no, sit.
Hey, please, you've got to let me explain.
I don't want an explanation. It's humiliating.
But you mustn't think.
I don't think anything. I don't care. Sid, if it's about you and Gladys, it has nothing to do with me.
But it is your business.
Who the hell did that? I'm talking about something bigger.
Well, this is just great. Can't we even talk to each other and make sense anymore?
I don't see how. Not until this is over.
I've eaten my llama long enough. I've had it.
Then what do you suggest, Sid? I can't. I have a date. I'll break it.
Sid, I hope to warn you, Bert is not fool this time. You've been out of all my screaming and yelling.
Just calm yourself, Gladys. I'll fix everything. I'll take him aside and tell him the whole story. In the meantime, here's your key.
Listen, I thought I heard something. Ah, no, no!
You made me act a fool. Hide it. What?
I told you I heard something.
Heard something, all right. I'm just glad he's got that out of the system.
How do you know that he has? How do you know
that? Right now, Gladys, everything will just be fine. Now you.
Ah, you gotta stop him.
I'll fix that, baby.
Now look, I don't like this. That's not nuts. This is totally pocket smoking.
I'd better explain, Mr. Hassler.
I think someone better.
Ah, no!
You're gonna kill me!
Oh, stop that.
Boss, I'm breaking the rules.
Yes, sir.
Why are we? They can warn the gangsters from Chicago. You don't have to vote again.
I don't think so, Mr. Hassler.
You're arguing with me. Can't you see those guys? That's the mark of foreigners.
If you don't, I'm going before the board and tell them the situation and tell them how many orders have been canceled.
Not one single damn order!
Each mail, there's a dozen cancellations. They will try all day yesterday trying to tell you about Bart's decline. Now, if this operation holds up, I hold up with it. And I don't want to. So do me a favor. Sit down and talk to me.
Yeah.
2.5 cents if you drop your claim for retroactive pay.
Hey, we ain't giving up nothing.
Now say it. I don't know.
Well, I do. Let's get it over. We've won!
We won!
I don't want to be kissed for something that strikes. Of course, if it's anything personal.
Oh, it's very personal.
Embarrassing, I call it.
I love you.
Tell me.
I love you.
Tell me.
I love you.
Tell me more.
More than a lion loves his cub.
More than a lion loves his cub.
More than a puppet loves his bear.
More than a buzzer loves his chin.
Yeah.
our backstage crew. Okay.